Hello. As you saw by the title, I'm gonna be showing you guys how to do like a blowout type look with using only the Dyson. I am gonna be putting in rollers as well, but I'm gonna show you how to do it without rollers. One of the main reasons why I wanted to do this video is because I have seen so many videos of people that got the Dyson for Christmas and they don't know how to use it. So we're mainly gonna be focusing on this part of the Dyson. If you wanna see my first impressions and me using the Airwrap tools, I did a video on like, is the Dyson actually worth it or not? Yeah, I only bought the Dyson for a YouTube video. I don't know if I would have ever been able to bring myself to buy this unless I was like a millionaire, because it is very, very expensive. But now that I have it, I totally understand the hype over it. It's an amazing product. And you know, I'm not really the type of person to hype up super expensive products because I think it's very annoying how expensive it is, but every single product you're getting in it is good quality. So I have actually used this thing quite a bit. I'm not gonna lie, I love this thing so much. And my hair has been so much healthier. Let me just show you guys something. When I tell you guys I have been on the hunt for the perfect round blow dryer brush, I'm not lying. So I'm gonna take you through these really quickly. Of course, the Revlon Hot Round Brush. Everyone knows what this thing is. Is it a good product? Yes. Do most people use it wrong, including myself? Yes. In the beginning of when I was using this, I used it completely wrong. I used it on sopping wet hair, and I used it on the highest setting, and I damaged my hair so much with this product. But it's definitely a good product. Sometimes if I'm in a rush and I need to do my hair, I'll use this because it's so big and it gets your hair done quicker. This is also a Revlon Hot Round Brush, but it has a detachable head, and this is titanium instead of ceramic. I do like this one better than this one because it is a little bit smaller too, so it gives it more of a bevel at the ends. Both of these are amazing. This is by the brand Amika. This is just a hot round brush. It's not a blow dryer brush, so it just gets hot. I like this if I want more of a curl. This is really, really good. I love this brand. And this is Conair. This is their Infinity Pro line. This one is probably one of my least favorites. I do like it because it has a good cool setting and an easy button to like shoot cold air. It's just not that powerful, and this one kind of sucks, I'm not gonna lie. But this one is also the Infinity Pro Conair, and this one's actually really, really good. I remember I did a TikTok on this one. It almost got like 500,000 likes. This blow dryer round brush probably gives the closest results to the Dyson in my opinion, and it has a cool setting and stuff. It's gonna damage your hair a little bit more than the Dyson because the Dyson, it's like made to be better for your hair. But if you're on a budget and you want to get the same exact results that I'm gonna get in this video, this works really, really good. But all right, now we're gonna get into the video. My hair is damp and I took a shower earlier, and I did put some products in my hair already because I like to do it right after the shower. The brand Redken 25 Benefits, it detangles, it has heat protectant, it's for frizz. I go in, brush my hair, and then one of my favorite all-time products that I have come across is Qi Silk Infusion, and I massage that like all throughout my hair. It has heat protection in it and it will make your hair so soft, so shiny. This is like one of my favorite hair products ever. And then of course my Olaplex bonding oil. Main reason why I use this is because it has heat protection, so whenever I'm gonna use heat, I always put this in my hair. My hair is brushed out. You really want to make sure to not have any knots in your hair when you're going in with a round brush, because that's just like asking to get your hair stuck into it. Okay, so the whole entire bottom section is not going to be put into rollers. This section doesn't really need it. The more I've done this, the more I've just realized it doesn't need it. This is one of my holy grail items to make my hair stay. It's the Amika Blowout Spray. I don't actually spray it directly on my hair, but I'll spray it into my hand and I'll do a few spritz, and I'll go on my hair and mainly put it on my bottoms because I really want the bevel to hold in the bottom of my hair. What it's doing is it's like adding a little bit of texture so your hair will stay. So it has a bunch of buttons and I'm gonna explain what all of them are. So this is just the power button. And honestly, compared to a lot of round brushes and blow dryers and stuff that I've used, this is like pretty quiet compared to the other one. It's like muffled, if that makes sense. And then these are the heat settings. There's cool, there's the medium one, and then the hottest. I usually go for the medium one. And then there's three fan settings. If you have a Dyson, you'll figure out like what fan setting you like. And then on the power button, you can see it has this little blue dot right here. So when you turn it on, you can actually hold it up and it'll shoot cold air out. And I'm gonna show you how to do it, but you use it after you're done done styling it and you hold it there and you shock it with cold air, so then your style locks in, because when your style cools, it like locks in the style. And for the blowout, I am mainly going to be using the round brush attachment. I don't know if you can see in the back, my hair does have quite a bit of wave to it, but I put a bunch of products in it and it's weighing it down, and I brushed it completely out. So if I do that, I can get away with just using this and my hair will straighten out while I'm doing it. But if your hair is a little bit wavier or curlier, you could probably go in with the I forgot what these are called, but the little brushes that come with it. So I take sections about this size, not super duper big. What I'm gonna first do is I'm gonna go through the hair. This way I kind of go slow-ish, but not so slow that it's gonna be like burning my hair. And then I go on the other side, go on top, and then I go on the bottom, and that's really smoothing out the hair. I'm going to go under, and I sometimes wrap it and I'll bring it like this. And then I will go on the ends like this to really make sure they bevel and curl. And you want to be going under. If you want volume in your roots and for it to like be voluminous, you need to go under, because then it's gonna have more volume because it's redirecting away from your roots. And then I will roll it up at the very end, hold it there for a second, and then shock it with cold air. And then when I let it out, I curl it like this while I'm letting it go. And then I will just let it sit like that in that like curl. And then I'm gonna brush it out at the very, very end, but I let it sit like that so it cools in that position, so then it like locks into place. Hopefully all of that made sense, but now I'm gonna show you like how I actually do it. Sometimes I will let it sit in here for a second, go out, I just curl it out of it. Very easy. And then you can already see it has like a bevel at the end. And I'm gonna let it sit like that. It kind of just depends. I don't really go away from my face or towards my face. It kind of, like, I don't really care. I'm just gonna do that all around the bottom section. This is the back section all done, very smooth. In the next sections, I am going to be going in with some Velcro Why can I not say the word Velcro? I am gonna be going in with some Velcro rollers and be pinning them. You could do what I did to the bottom to your whole entire head. Whenever I put rollers in, they seem to last a little bit longer and they have more of a defined curl and they look more voluminous. I just like the rollers, but section off just the top section for now. This is literally the same exact thing. And I still take it out exactly the same way, and I actually roll it while it's like curled. I'm gonna show you guys what I mean. So, I take it out like this, with it like being curled. I make sure the bottom is the same direction that the roller is. You don't want to put it on the opposite way. And then I roll it under. You never want to pin it on the top. You always want to pin it right here so then they don't crease. So yeah, I'm just gonna do that pretty much all over my head. That's it. Side is fully done. I'm gonna go do the other side off camera, and then we will do the top section. I'm gonna go under for this one, and then for the next one I'm going to be going this way. But the reason why I do that is because I feel like this one sits like that and then the other one curls up. The difference makes your hair look more full and it looks like there's some like more layers. I don't know, it just like looks better. You guys will see. For this section, I'm going to be taking it in the front and rolling it like this. So for the curtain bangs, I start out by rolling underwards. I don't think that's a word. I start out by rolling under, like right at the root, and it's giving you volume at your root, so then it's not flat. And then after that, I go over like this, and I wanna make sure the roller's kind of placed up and it's not sagging in front of my face, because then there will be no volume. Put these pins on there because I have some shorter hairs that will fall out. And then for these little layer pieces, I'm just gonna roll them back. You can leave these in for 10 minutes. You can leave them in for 30. You can leave them in for like 3 hours. I've done it all. And I've heard a lot of people say that it doesn't matter how long you leave them in, they just have to cool. I disagree with that to a certain extent, because the longer I leave them in, the better they turn out. If I wait 30 minutes and all of them are completely cooled, it'll still look amazing, but it would look more amazing if I left it in for 3 hours. I'm back. All right, just kidding. I think I forget to do this every single time. I'm gonna take some dry shampoo and just spritz that in my roots. It helps it hold a little bit better, and you always wanna spray your hair with dry shampoo before it gets oily, because then when your hair gets oily, it's instantly absorbed, and then you don't have to like ever deal with oily hair. I mean, until it does eventually get oily and you have to wash it, but that's one of my favorite hair tricks. All right, now I'll see you in like 20-ish minutes. Okay, I accidentally maybe kept these in for like a couple hours. I got food and I laid in bed and forgot I was filming. Always start from the bottom. She's voluminous. You don't need to do the rollers, but it does give you more volume and it makes your hair last a little bit longer. I just wanted to do this video because I've been getting a lot of questions on this. I've been getting separate questions on like what my hair styling routine has been recently. So, and then all day I just like flip through my hair. I want to get more layers really bad. It's literally an addiction. And then sometimes if my ends are a little bit dry, I'll put some hair oil in them, but they're honestly like fine right now. All right, but I think that's it for this video. All right. Sometimes I get really awkward and I don't know how to end my videos. Thank you for watching. Bye.
I don't know if you like the way I put my words together, but I need you to stick with me just like some birds of feathers. My life brings the scales hand to hand, dropping corn straight down the well. Wish me well, wish me well. Always talking about the fishing scales, things that's gon' throw my mind off focus. Probably what's gon' get my drug use more dosage. Like a damn baby girl, I didn't think you noticed.